chopper, I ain't on the ball. Well, I'm a slow moving popper, last on the draw. Well, I'm a slow moving popper, but your woman's at my door. I woke up this morning, it was 9:30. I went back to bed, cause it was way too soon. I'm a slow moving popper, your woman don't like it fast. Well, I'm a slow moving popper, so slow I'm in the past. Let's do it now. Woman goes to work, then I lay my head down. She's a rubber-legged woman, had a bouncing round and round. I'm a slow-moving popper, well, I'm always late. Well, I'm a slow-moving popper, but your woman thinks I'm great. Here we go now. Just one thing that I want understood. Do it real slow, but I do it real good. I'm a slow-moving popper, she likes it slow. Well, I'm a slow-moving popper, a no, no, go, go, go. Well, I'm a slow-moving, a slow-moving popper, a slow-moving daddy. Slow down, your pretty little mama. Take care of your slow-moving papa. I'm a slow-moving papa, but your woman's at my door.
Job and not one to raise and pay. Now she's in the typing pool at minimum wage.
Thank you guys very much. You're too kind.
Who stole that train on the track? Whoever took it better come and put it back. I heard that engine whistle blow, it should have been here long ago. Who stole that train off the track? My baby wrote and said that she was coming home on 93. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Been waiting here since early dawn. The thief was here, but now she's gone. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Who stole that train off the track? Whoever took it better come and put it back. If someone playing jokes on me, they better let my baby be. Oh, who stole that train off the track? I looked and saw a cloud of steam. I plainly heard a whistle scream. Oh, who stole that train off the track? I looked again with all my might, but still no engine come inside. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Who stole that train off the track? Who stole that choo-choo that was bringing baby back? Somebody must have pulled the switch and run a train into a ditch. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Up yonder in the sky and saw the smoke rising high. Oh, who stole that train off the track? That smoke was hanging in the air, but ain't no baby anywhere. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Who stole that train off the track? Whoever took it better come and put it back. My baby wouldn't make me wait. She'd walk home if the train was late. Oh, who stole that train off the track?
a strange kind of feeling, but baby don't love me no more. Got a strange kind of feeling, but baby don't love me no more. Well, my baby let me walk right out the door. My baby don't love me no more. Well, my baby let me walk right out that door. Tell me, baby, please tell me. Tell me, baby, please tell me. Tell me, baby, make my dreams come true. Check it out. Dig it. Love it. Live it. Huh? Yeah. How about that? How about that, Xander? Uh-huh. Check it. Nothing that this Burt character can't do? Oh, is that? You look kind of sexy with the hair messed up like that. Don't get me started. Let him know how you feel. As a matter of fact, pick up your phone. Visit that virtual tip jar.
Yeah, think about it.
trucking, trucking, trucking. I wrote this part of his solo, by the way.
We had this switchover planned. It was going to be so smooth. We were going to use all our own instruments.
2020!
I think this is right.
Nothing goes smooth in 2020.
Tender now.
Uh-huh. All right. Slap it, baby, just like you used to slap Lydia.
Go ahead. Big bottom time. I'll go first now. Straight forward. All right, here we go. Go, Dick.
Getting a good sound out of that thing, Deke. It's that UK sound that we all love so much. Got a strange kind of feeling, my baby don't love me no more. Got a strange kind of feeling, Elmo James don't love me no more. Well, my baby let me walk that out that door. Baby, please tell me. Tell me, Mama, will make my dreams come true. Oh, then rock me, will rock me, will rock me, will rock me, will dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee, make my dreams come true.
Thank you very much, friends. I'm Deke Dickerson, Mr. Big Sandy, Bert Avalos, Xander Griffith, the Whippersnappers. Thank you so much.
Great gosh almighty, Deke Dickerson and the Whippersnappers, everybody.
Welcome, Honky Tonkers. Our show today is volume one of a musical series that explores some of our most respected and beloved honky tonk heroes. These are not just the honky tonk classics, and they're certainly not the top 40 country hits. No, these are the honky tonk heroes chosen by some of our favorite musicians, artists who wrote songs that stand the test of time. The swinging two-steppers, the waltzes, and the country rockers that still make you want to get out on that honky-tonk hardwood floor. Ernest Tubbs' I'm Walking the Floor Over You is known as the first honky-tonk song, jump-starting the genre in 1941. But it wasn't until the 1950s that honky-tonk achieved mainstream popularity. Now, over the past 50 years, I am proud to say I've danced at honky-tonks in over 25 states, from New York City to the Midwest, and all over the South and the West Coast. I can tell you something about honky-tonking around. Honky-tonk attitude means you are there for the music, the dancing, and the drinking, maybe not in that order. That may be why I have worn holes in the soles of my cowboy boots. Most of these have been resold at least once. Whether you're there for a tear in your beer, a whiskey river, or the honky-tonk blues, these juke joints are your home away from home. Some are tiny, like LA's Cinema Bar. Some are large, like Hernando's Hideaway in Memphis. And some are huge, like Billy Bob's Texas in Fort Worth. But they all share the same thing, a stage, a dance floor, and a bar, and the diverse musicians who make it all happen. Today, our video host, music historian Big Sandy, and special musical guests like Dave Alvin, Jesse Dayton, and Deke Dickerson are going to share their honky-tonk heroes with you. We are going to kick it off with a serious honky-tonker who has made music with Waylon, Willie, Chris, and Johnny in his honky-tonk career. Who can doubt his country credentials after he wrote the song, "I'm at home getting hammered while she's out getting nailed"? He won Honky Tonk Artist of the Year at the Ameripolitan Awards and is the host of his own Gimme Country radio station. Welcome from Austin, the outlaw Jesse Dayton.
Hey, hey, thanks, Chris. Got my old Martin here. How y'all doing? If you don't know who I am, my name's Jesse Dayton. I'm from an old Texas family, and I was raised on honky-tonk music and rockabilly music, and my family's an old Beaumont, Texas family, which is right on the Louisiana-Texas border, so I grew up listening to a lot of Zydeco and Cajun music and rhythm and blues, and quite a colorful place to grow up. We had, up until like the late 80s, we had 24-hour Cajun DJ stations where they spoke nothing but French. It'd be, "Ay, comment se va, chère baby," and a lot of honky-tonk, a lot of country music came out of Beaumont, Starday Records, and so much stuff. A lot of the classic guys that I got to play with later told me great stories. Johnny Bush told me great stories about him and Lefty Frizzell recording in Beaumont. And anyway, most musicians, guitar slingers, I made it out and went to Austin. That's where, we all wanted to be if you were a Texan. And so I ended up in Austin, and I remember Clifford Antone, who Antone's Blues Club, who was from Port Arthur, and his family knew my family in Beaumont. He's like, "Oh, kid, just learn these Buddy Guy records and come to the club, and I'll get you up on stage." So I did, and I was really young, and I got up and I sang, and he goes, "Your voice is pretty country." And Clifford put me in his Continental car and took me over to the Broken Spoke and introduced me to James White. And I got up on stage. James got me up on stage. This is the first night ever to play in Austin. And I just played Antone's earlier with a house band, did a couple of songs, sang one song. And then I went up and sang a Johnny Bush song. And I was like, "Okay, yeah, this is where I'm supposed to be." Because Austin had this amazing classic country scene. We had a big rockabilly scene. It's like every Monday and Tuesday, like the two worst nights of the week, you could go to the Continental Club, the Black Cat Lounge, the Hole in the Wall, Antone's, the Broken Spoke. They'd all be packed, and people would be dressed to the nines. So eventually, I got a record deal, and I was in Nashville, and I was promoting this record I had out on this television show called Crook and Chase, which was a square kind of, it seemed like one of those Christian broadcasting networks where everybody's just super uptight. And I'm in there with my, pompadour, sideburns, and tattoos, and I do not fit in. And that night, I met Christofferson on the show. Because this publicist had seen me at the Continental Club and said, "Hey, I'm going to get you on this show. You're never going to get on the radio, but I'll get you on this show." So I met Chris, and it was a great night. And me and Christofferson ended up hanging out the whole night together. We went outside and we, you know, smoked a little bit of Willie's jazz tea. And then we went to the Gibson Guitar Factory, which they opened at like 9 o'clock at night for Chris. And then we just sat around and talked about books and talked about Bukowski and songwriters and Hank Williams. And it was great. And I was like, okay, that's great. It's all over. And then that next morning, I was staying out in this dump because I couldn't even afford to stay next to Music Row, like this Motel 6. And my phone rings, and it's Waylon Jennings. And Waylon goes, hey, I saw you on TV last night, Hoss. Why don't you come down and pick some guitar for me? And it was a deal changer. So I ended up playing on all the guitar on the next Waylon Jennings record. And that opened up a lot of doors for me. And I ended up playing on a whole Ray Price record. And I recorded with Johnny Cash and recorded with Willie Nelson and Johnny Bush. And it just kept going on and on for a while. And I got to meet Billy Joe Shaver because we ended up on the same record label. And I also met him through Waylon. And those two were such a hoot. They were so cool to hang out with. And Billy Joe, you know, just passed away not long ago. And I built a big old fire pit in my backyard and call it the Billy Joe Shaver fire pit. But anyway, there's a lot of stories. And I'm actually writing a book for this publishing company called DiCapo Book Publishing, which is going to have all these stories and in it. But anyway, there you have it. Thanks for listening to me ramble, and here's some way more Jennings.
Low down, leaving son. Done did everything it was done. Woe is me, why can't I see? I best believe in well enough alone. Where does it go? The good Lord only knows. Seemed like it was just the other day. I was down in Green Gables, hogging them tables, and generally blowing all my hard-earned pay. By any road blue, weren't another way to be. For them lovable losers, no account losers, and honky-tonk heroes like me. Thank you.
Hey y'all, this next video is one of my favorites. Filmed right here in Austin at the legendary Continental Club. I was supposed to be in this video. So many of my friends are, but I was actually on tour. I think I was up in Canada or Seattle at the time. But yeah, it's got Billy Joe Shaver's son just melting faces on his guitar, Eddie Shaver. Great guitar player. And to me, it's just one of the greatest all-time hillbilly rock and roll songs ever. Anyway, this is Billy Joe Shaver doing the hottest thing in town.
She's the queen of the red hot mama, hottest thing around. When she shows up at a honky tonk, 'cause she can righteously get down, you know she get on down, from down to the ground. She's a cat's meow and a dog's bow wow, the hottest thing in town. A friend of a friend of a friend of mine said he knew her well. Said she hung around heaven till she learned too much, then she headed straight for hell. She went straight to hell. Everything for sale. Walks it walk and talks it talk, the hottest thing in town. She's the hottest thing in town by country mile.
I just want to say thanks so much for letting me be a part of this. Thank you, Christopher. Also, I'd be remiss if I didn't bring up my dear friend, Big Sandy, who's just a legend, and I've known him for so long. Like, I don't know when it was. It was the early 90s, maybe, when my little band first opened up for the original Big Sandy outfit with TK, and High Noon was on that gig. You guys might remember that band, High Noon. We were playing a rockabilly festival at the Hole in the Wall in Austin. Yeah, I love Robert. I love everything you do, man. You're not just a rockabilly singer. You know, hillbilly boogie and western swing and honky tonk and doo-wop and just so much there. So anyway, thanks for letting me be a part of this. God bless you guys, and hopefully we'll see you back on tour in the near future. Take care.
Thank you, Jesse, and welcome, music lovers. Big Sandy here, very happy to be part of today's presentation, Honky Tonk Heroes, Volume 1. And my favorite part about that equation is that it's Volume 1, meaning more episodes to come. Today, I'll be sharing but a few of my many honky tonk heroes. All right, let's get started. Warren Smith, first recorded for Sam Phillips at Sun Records in Memphis, and he laid down some of the finest examples of rockabilly ever committed to wax with songs like Got Love If You Want It, Rock and Roll Ruby, and Miss Froggy. But mixed in with all of that beautiful rock and roll madness at Sun, Warren Smith also recorded some sides that showed a real feel for true authentic country music. After he left Sun Records, Warren was signed to the Liberty record label, where he went on to release some of my all-time favorite honky-tonk records and what I think is one of the greatest country music albums of all time. Here he is, live on the Gene Williams Country Junction, the great Warren Smith.
I guess you never met her, boy, but she was a dream. Was a queen, my everything. One night we had a quarrel, and I don't know what for. She walked through the door with all my dreams. That's why I sing in a honky tonk where lights are low. Broken
Burkhardt's hearts by hundreds, I see them come and go. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk sad melody, so this broken heart of mine will have some company. This is where she left me, boy, and here's where I'll stay. Here I will play my life away, hoping for the day to come when she will return. Her kisses will burn my hurt away. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk where lights are low. Broken hearts by hundreds, I see them come and go. That's why I sing in a honky-tonk sad melody, so this broken heart of mine will have some company.
Thank you very much.
Was I farther from your conscience standard, face to the war? I suspected there was something that you weren't telling me. And last night I learned the reason for it all. I was looking through your window, saw you kissing someone else. You reached up and turned my picture slowly face to the wall, face to the wall, so you wouldn't have to see anything at all to make you think of me. Did the cheapness of the moment make you feel ashamed and small? Was I farther from your conscience standing face to the wall? Alone out in the darkness were the eyes that worship you. As you cheated me, I watched my idol fall. Your arms around did nothing, his lips where mine should be. Then I saw you turn my picture slowly face to the wall, face to the wall, so you wouldn't have to see anything at all to make you think of me. In the cheapness of the moment make you feel ashamed and small? Was I farther from your conscience standing face to the wall?
Oh my goodness, what can I say? Pure.